food in our bodies, there's a lot of, you know, many people have different reasons why we eat certain things. One of the things I noticed, when you eat something, you also want it eliminated out of your body. So how do I test food is, I mean, I don't do this now, but anybody can do this. Grab a stainless steel pot, throw the one substance of that food you plan on eating, boil it down with some water, and you'll see when you do boil it completely down what the residue is. And that's the residue is going to stay inside your own body trapped. And if it's meat products, dairy, fish, eggs, so forth, you're going to have a pus, a white mucusy grossed up mucus. Mucus-forming foods is what these things are called, and this is what's going to stay inside your body for who knows how long. Now, if it's fruits and vegetables, especially fruits, if you boil them down, off and down, or just warm them up first and going down to a boil, you'll see that the fruits will become sweeter, a syrup. They'll become a syrup, or some people call it molasses, it will be. Some people will eat it and enjoy it, but the fact is, this will leave your body much quicker than the mucus will. The mucusy, white, pussy, sticky stuff is what you'll do for glue. If you want a book bind, perfect. If you want to use it for carpenter's glue, perfect. That's what you do. When people talk about a horse race, and if the horse doesn't win, they kill the horse and they produce glue out of the horse's flesh, that's what you're putting in your body. Flesh, you know, glue.
So people are eating glue?
Yeah, absolutely. They're eating glue. Like a little kid in kindergarten is still stuck on eating glue. And they haven't stopped 40 or 50 years in their life. They're still eating glue.
I mean, we know dairy products have, milk has a lot of casein, right? And they used to make buttons out of them.
Yeah, it's a plasticky, gluey, crappy, nasty stuff. So yeah. Why would you want to continue putting stuff in your body that constricts you, that restricts you, causes scarcity and disease, and that's all animal product?
Yeah, that's true. When you cook milk,
yeah,
and then you want to wash the pot, you have to scrub it hard and put detergent inside, yeah?
Yeah.
So basically the stomach and the digestive system is a little bit like that pot, because the temperature is higher, and a similar process has to occur for the body to assimilate, for the body to digest everything, right?
The process of removing it out of the body, absolutely.
Yeah.
Why do you want to cause more issues for it to eliminate from your body? And plus the milk itself, when people consume milk, it's been treated, manipulated, whatever you want to call it, you know, same with the meats. So it's a lot more burden for your body to even take in. It cannot absorb the protein and fats and anything else. It's just a burden, just an obstacle.
Yeah, one time you said, hey, if I told you, what was it about the cow nipple?
Oh yeah, if I told you, it's got this, get something to eat. You know, I can't stand, you know, just hanging out here and I want ice cream. But let's go to the nearest farm and suck on a cow's nipple and put sugar on it. I mean, that's pretty much what we're doing with dairy, with ice creams and sour creams and yogurts. We're sucking a cow's nipple, but even worse, we're letting it rot. You know, we're sucking nipples that are rotting, you know, with pus and mucus and fecal matter and vomit.
Yeah, so cheese is rotten milk?
Absolutely, it's rotten, nasty, doesn't occur in nature. No, there's no way you can make, it's not gonna happen in nature. When's the last time a human mother, you know, was feeding their baby, and if they squeeze some of their breast milk into a glass or some sort of container, just look at it, see how it becomes cheese. It won't become cheese, it'll become some rotten, nasty, putrid stuff. Mm-hmm. Quickly too, very fast. Yeah. Same thing with the cow's milk.
Yeah, usually moms and babies don't waste any drop of milk, right?
No, that's crazy.
That's right. So what about honey? What about raw honey, which is so popular nowadays?
Well, using the word raw is very popular, but the fact is honey is what it is. It's the vomit from a bee, and it's going to have the stomach containments of those bees, and it's meant for their own purposes, but it does cause acidity in the body. It does cause a lot of damage to the human body. I mean, the way I look at it is, if you don't need it, don't eat it. You know, you can live fine without honey. And at the same time, if you have to eat sugar, you have to eat water with your that honey stuff or whatever. Anytime you're required to consume water, and if you do eat any kind of meats and dairies and fish and eggs, even honey, you'll see that you get thirsty and you have to drink water. That's a sure sign that you've been poisoned. If I eat nothing but oranges one day, a whole sitting of oranges or watermelon or apples, I do not need to drink any water. You know, I could, that's just fine, but I don't need to drink it. But if I were to eat nothing but the meats and the fish and the cheese or the honey, chug down some honey, I'll get very thirsty. My throat would feel very parched. It's because it's literally removing the water out of my own cells.
So what is honey in the essence?
It's poison. It's just simply poison. Don't drink
Okay, what is poison? How do you define what's poison?
For me, poison is anything that the body doesn't need. It's a burden. It causes more burden than if you drink enough of it. I'm sure you'd probably collapse and die too much of that stuff. It's so refined. Honey is so refined of a sugar that I'd rather eat. I would much rather have refined sugar, like white sugar, even though I wouldn't have it, but I'm just saying processed sugar, I would rather have maple syrup I'll have over bees as an example. There's such a process of honey that it's directly, and it forces the body, your human body, to, you know, the insulin response is so great, you're gonna have an insulin shock.
Mm-hmm. Why would you? So how do the bees get honey? Oh, what do they? What do
nectar.
They?
They suck the nectar, and then they store it. They regurgitate the nectar, and they vomit it. They vomit it, and this is storage for their babies, for their future generations.
So we steal it.
Yeah, we're stealing it.
So we humans steal bee vomit.
And by that token, if you go by definition of a parasite, that is the definition of a parasite, because we're doing no benefit to the host. So we're feeding off the bees like a parasite to a host, and the bees get no benefit for us doing this.
Wow, interesting.
Yeah, I don't want to be a parasite. That's why my diet of only fruits has benefited me, because I'm not a parasite, and I don't consider myself a scavenger.
Yeah, especially after a bee vomit.
Especially after bee vomit. You know, and some people will say, well, what benefit do you have of eating fruits? Well, very simple. Eat the fruits, you poop out the seeds, plant tree, you know, the whole process. It's, if you have a clean bowel system, you'll see nothing but fruits come out of you. You won't see that with bee honey or meat or flesh, none of that stuff. Hmm. Oh.